We're there within about 2 minutes for his gator attack in the pond that's over by the grocery store.
A man is recovering tonight from severe injuries after an alligator ripped into his arm on Sanibel this morning. The man was rinsing his hands in a pond next to Bailey's grocery store on Periwinkle Way when the gator lunged at him. A doctor who you just heard from treated the victim and says his injuries could have been a lot worse.
NBC2's Alicia Alonso is local on Sanibel with some new information on how the man saved himself.
Sanibel police say that gator attacked this man while he was washing his hands in a pond next to Bailey's grocery store. When medics got here, they found him bleeding from his arm. They say he made a smart decision that ended up saving his life.
If you're not careful, this absolutely can happen.
A 9-foot gator attacked a 25-year-old man at the pond next to Bailey's General Store. The gator went after his arm. Dr. Benjamin Abo with Sanibel Fire says the man was able to pull himself out of the water and called police, tying up his wound before medics arrived.
He had very substantial injuries that could have been life-threatening if not addressed quickly with something like a tourniquet. And he had actually started to self-apply a tourniquet, which is one of the things that saved him.
Crews rushed the man to the hospital where his arm is expected to be saved. Trappers removed the gator they believe bit him. But you don't have to look too hard on Sanibel to find a gator. Another NBC2 reporter took these photos last week of a gator about 2 miles away from today's attack, near the shack also on Periwinkle Way. Wildlife officials say gator bites like this can be prevented.
The most important aspect would be prevention. If you understand what puts people at risk for certain things, this is why you don't walk in high grass in flip-flops, because there might be snakes around. Again, we're in their area, not ours. Be careful around water's edge, especially if it's brackish water.
Reporting local on Sanibel Island, Alicia Alonso, NBC2.
And according to FWC, there were a total of 9 alligator attacks in Florida last year, compared to 15 in 2013. The last gator death due to a gator attack that killed somebody was back in 2019. Alligators are most active as the sun goes down. Always keep a close eye on children and pets near ponds in Florida. And of course, never feed the gators. If you come across an alligator where it shouldn't be, stay away from it and call the FWC nuisance hotline.